Hey y'all, good morning. Let's walk over here to the job site, the cabin site, oh my goodness, what a gorgeous morning it is today. The breeze is just perfect. The temperature is perfect. The sun is shining. It is gorgeous. And we are getting our day started up here on the homestead. And what better way to start it than with AG1. AG1 is my nutritional supplement. I drink it in the mornings and it helps me starting to get myself back in shape, starting to get myself a little healthier, a little happier, and a little more energetic up here on the homestead. I got a lot of work to do, and to get that done, I have to start taking care of myself better, y'all. So, started drinking this nutritional drink called AG1. And yes, it is a pretty green color, and it tastes good. It has almost a candy-like taste to it. It's amazing. I love it. And start the day off every morning with this. I've been doing that for a few weeks now. And AG1 is sponsoring today's video. But it's something I've been doing to try to encourage myself to get healthier. I've started drinking this wonderful nutritional drink in the mornings. Gives me more energy, boosts my mood, boosts my stress level, is a whole lot less with drinking this, because it has all these high quality vitamins and minerals. It's like 75 high quality vitamins and minerals in this stuff, and it is wonderful. It tastes good. It's refreshing and it's easy. Michelle, you'll be putting it together this morning. AG1 supports your brain, gut, and immune system through micronutrients, phytonutrients, and essential symbiotics. It's made up of 75 high-quality ingredients to nourish all your body's systems holistically. It tastes really good and gets your day started, giving you essential vitamins and minerals, including ones like biotin, zinc, and others to aid in healthy aging. Powerful plant extracts and adaptogenic herbs and antioxidants to balance your stress and mood. Plus, gives you a variety of vitamins to encourage focus and energy throughout your day without that caffeine crash. So make sure you go down here to this link below. AG1 is going to give my community a free 1-year supply of AG vitamin D3 plus K2 and 5 travel packs with your first purchase. Thank you, AG1, for sponsoring today's video. It is definitely helping me on this homestead getting things done, y'all. Jax, do you agree? You agree? Jax agrees. Alright, y'all. It's time to get to work on this homestead. Check out AG1. Link is below. And thank them for sponsoring the video for me to help build this homestead, to help build this cabin. And let's get to work. Good morning, y'all. We are going to work again today. I don't know if this is part of the last video or if it's a new video, but you know what? We're saying hey anyway because, yeah, it's a brand new day. And got our supplies in the wagon. What we need to work today. And let's show you what we got going on here. Look at that. It is going to be a 20 foot by 20 foot tiny house. 400 square feet. Itty bitty. But not as itty bitty as it looked with the 16 by 16. Anyway, I've got to put that and that and that. Those three. I've got to go right here. For the floor joists for this middle part. And look who says hello. Good morning. Good morning, Jax. And so right here I'm gonna put three more floor joists. Really technically I only need two here, but I'm gonna put a third just because I want this really strong. This is where the bathtub is gonna sit, the clawfoot tub right here. I say clawfoot tub, but we never know. Hopefully I'll be able to afford to get a clawfoot tub once this is all said and done. So anybody got a hookup on a 48 to 52 inch clawfoot tub, let me know, because I want to put one in the bathroom there. All right, here we go. I'm just working on it. We'll bump this side out hopefully today. We'll see. Out of materials after this, I gotta go get some more of these boards. We were able to save, you saw in the last video or the first part of this one, I don't know, as you saw in the last portion of this floor build, that we were able to save the floor joists and I'll have to buy new ones. Woo-wee. Looking good. Looking good. You see how much bow we have on those boards over there? Look how high they are off of the middle. And they shouldn't be, but they are. They'll go down when we put the subfloor on. Get it nailed on and start walking on it. They'll adjust. No big deal. Let's get some ledger boards, some girders, and some floor joists on this front part. Time to get to work, y'all. Time lapse. Here we go. Batteries are dead in all the batteries are dead. I've got 3 batteries I'm working with, and all 3 of them are dead. So time to go charge some batteries, get me some lunch, and then we'll come back out here and finish this. Got to cut this little corner off of here so that I can attach the extension to it and get this post over here in place. Okay. All right, let me clean up my mess here, get inside, eat myself some lunch, and then I can get back out here and get to work. Back from lunch, y'all. Charged this battery up some, not all the way, unfortunately, but charged it up some. And hopefully it's enough to get through this, because we ain't got much left to do today. So, let's see what we can do here. That's it for today. We're calling it. Got quite a bit done, and I'm happy with it. Very proud of what it's looking like now, and ready for the floor to be done. So, won't be long. Just gotta put these joists in on this side, and
get my quick read in there and set up and a few girders and ledger boards, and yeah, it's done. Then I'll be able to start my subfloor. So stick with me for that, and we'll get a floor on this thing and we'll do some dancing. All right, y'all, we'll see you on the next one. Love ya. Have a great week, great weekend, and God bless. Thank you, AG1, for sponsoring today's video.